Forecast accuracy. I mean, when it comes to forecasting, the rubber really meets the road when the time comes to build shift schedules for your agents. I mean, you want schedules that consistently match the supply of agents with demand from customers. And you need to take into account the peaks and troughs across the days of the week and the weeks of the month and so on, and the M curve or whatever across each working day. That, at the end of the day, is why we do forecasting. So you should start by taking a snapshot of your forecast at the moment you use it to create schedules. Now, a good workforce management application will have the means to do that. In injixo, it's called forecast versions. So the second step is after the event, so the days arrived, the weeks arrived, and you want to compare the actuals with what you saved in the forecast snapshot. Now, the tip here is be careful in choosing the evaluation time frame. Averages are dangerous. If I put my head in the oven, my feet in the freezer, on average, I'm comfortable, because it doesn't work out like that. On a typical day, there'll be some intervals that have got more volume than your forecast and other intervals with less volume than your forecast. And these two can cancel each other out. That's called compensating errors. So if you're just looking at daily or weekly totals, your forecast will probably look more accurate than it is. So what I recommend is use a technique in mind for measuring forecast accuracy. And what you're fundamentally doing is you're comparing the numbers in two columns, the forecast and the actual column. If you're into statistics, you can find all sorts of techniques for doing that comparison of the two columns. There's something called standard deviation, which is measuring the amount of noise or spread in a sample of data. And the bigger the number, the more the spread. You could use correlation coefficients, where a perfect match, perfect accurate forecast gives a score of 1 plus 1, and complete inaccuracy is minus 1. Thing is, they're quite difficult to interpret the results of those comparisons, so I recommend you use something called MAPE, MAPE, mean absolute percentage error. And there's a little image there showing the scary mathematical formula, but actually what it boils down to is something you can do easily with a spreadsheet. And there's a little example there showing at 50-minute intervals, forecast compared with actual, looking at the average, the absolute percentage error in each interval, and then averaging that across the day to give you a figure. So that's my first tip. Use mean absolute percentage error. It's powerful and easily understood. Another tip is don't forget average handling time. It's just as important with working out your workload, just as important as volume. Another tip is, what does good look like? Well, if you've got a center with at least 100 agents in, you should be aiming for within 5%, so a mean absolute percentage error of less than 5% or less. If you're a bit smaller than that, because you've now got the safety in numbers, then 10% is a reasonable target for a smaller center. And the final tip for measuring is, you've got to find the cause of deviations so you can avoid them next time.